Now let's look at one more question on the topic of hinge plates. Now the question says a jet of water 30 mm in dia, it strikes a hinged square plate at its center with a velocity of 20 meters per second. The plate is deflected through an angle of 20 degrees. Find the weight of the plate. Now if the plate is not allowed to swing, what will be the force required at the lower edge of the plate to keep the plate in vertical position? So if you look at the diagram for it, this is the hinge, this is the plate, okay, let's keep it vertical, okay. Now the water strikes at the center, moves up and moves down like this. Now initially let us say it is being deflected by an angle 20, so theta is 20. So for that part you need to find the weight of the plate. So if it is being deflected, the formula that we can use is sine theta is equal to rho a v square upon w. From here I need to find out w, because I know theta, I know density, I know velocity, I can find out area. Let's find out area. So area is pi by 4 into diameter square. So dia is what, 30 mm? Mm means 0.03 meters. So when you solve this, you get 0.007068 meter square. Okay, so area is done. So from this I can find out W. So W is 1000 into this angle, which is 0.007068, into velocity square. Velocity is 20, so it means 400, divided by sine theta, so sine of 20 degrees. So do the scientific calculator calculation and the value of the weight will come out to be 826.6 newtons. So this is the total weight of the plate when it is swinging. Okay, you have a deflection 20 degrees, but we don't want it to swing. So means I have to put a vertical force, or sorry, a horizontal force like this, P. So if the water is striking over here, it will try to deflect that side, but this force is keeping it vertical. It is not allowing it to deflect. So let us say this is point O and this entire distance is H from the hinge point to the point of application of this horizontal force P. And this F, this is being applied at the half of the total height. Okay, so in order to find out this force which is keeping the plate vertical and it is not allowing it to swing, we have to equate moments about point O. So with this, it will try and go in that direction, and with this it will try and go in that direction. So they are basically equal and opposite moments. So you will have P into H is equal to F into H by 2. Okay, so H and H gets cancelled. So basically it becomes half of the force due to the jet of water. Now this becomes a case of a stationary vertical plate. In the case of stationary vertical plate, the force was rho AB square upon 2. 2 is from this calculation, F is only this much. So let's put in the value. So you will get 1000 into 0.007068 into 4000 into 400 upon 2. This will give you 141.636 newtons. So approximately 141 newtons of force is required at point P to keep this plate from deflecting by a jet of water striking at its center. So I hope you got this question. It's a very simple question and almost straightforward application of the formula used. So I hope you got the topic of a vertical plate which is hinged at the top. Now let's move on to the next topic and talk about the force exerted by jets onto moving plates.